196 feet long and 194 feet wide, it's bigger than 3.5 football fields. Miles. From Ningbo, the ship will sail across the bay to Shanghai, then down the South China Sea to Tanjung Pelepas, Malaysia. After one last big load, cross the Indian Ocean to meet up with a scheduled convoy through the Suez Canal. Then it will sail through the Mediterranean past Gibraltar and sail up through the English Channel en route to the German ports of Bremerhaven and Hamburg. It's a 30-day, 12,000-mile voyage.
For me to be on the Oscar, I say, oh my God, the biggest ship in the world.
This massive workhorse sails the globe.
In China, we have too much stress.
Boat approaching.
Like harbor pilot Sung Yin Jun. Engineer Francesco Di Gennaro is searching for clues why the engine automatically slowed down.
Okay, main engine detects alarm on crank being number 70 apparently.
A spike in temperature poses a worst-case threat for Francesco. Engine failure.
Manover is one of the most critical moments for the engine. Continually start, stop, then as engine, you are all the time afraid of this.
But he knows leaving port is the priority. So Francesco shuts off the minor alarm and heads to the engine room. The ship sails on. After 20 minutes of problem solving,
this time, luckily, was the sensors feedback failure.
It turns out the engine's powerful vibrations during departure loosened wires on the heat sensor. The result? A false alarm. We'll be right back.
Turkish, good evening.
Yeah.
Now should be 1 hour, should be pilot. Now we give notice to you 1 hour before, and we go like usually to prepare main engine. Yeah.
Third officer, Yubo Donkovic, reviews the navigational controls on the bridge.
We start main engine, we start bow thruster, we start rudder pumps, we put the route on the electronic charts, we switch on the VHF equipment for communication, and vessel is ready to sail.
The ship is ready to leave.